Music. Music is a very important part of our lives. From the time we are born into our growing phase, even our latter years, we become closely dependent on music.
Music has the power to alter our moods, our emotions, our perception of joy and sorrow. Without music, a festival will not seem as much fun, and a wedding would just be a tedious ritual.
But Shalini, did you know that apart from our minds, music also affects our bodies?
Indeed, music is very effective in producing a deep and a healing state of relaxation. It is also very efficient in reducing stress.
Let me tell you about an interesting incident mentioned in the book written by Vimal Kumar Mohanlal Dami. It's about musician Pandit Motiram. In the year 1932, the Nizam of Adalabad had many concerts by musician Pandit Motiram. In these concerts, many various people used to attend, one of which was Dr. Lakshmikant Rao Deshpande, who used to attend Panditji's all concerts. But for continuously two or three concerts, he was not to be seen. So Panditji decided to pay him a visit. On arriving to his house, he realized that the doctor was burning with fever. Panditji told him that, "Doctor, you always monitor injections to us to cure us of our ailments, but today I am going to monitor injection on you." At this, the doctor started laughing. Panditji paid no heed to him and made him listen to one of his ragas. And miraculously, the doctor's fever vanished. Born in the Mewati Gharana of Jodhpur in the year 1889, Pandit Motiram is none other than the father of singer Pandit Jasraj. The doctor was given nothing but a dose of music and raga therapy.
Music and raga therapy is an established alternate therapy that uses the power of music and classical raga to improve the quality of life of healthy people as well as in improving the health of people with illness.
It is believed that Indian classical music has the capability to surround the listener with a deep and calming mood effect, the same he gets when he envisions a sunset. As the music floats into the atmosphere, it surrounds the listener with a sense of healing and relaxation.
Indeed, when a person listens to soft and soothing music, happiness molecules are released in his or her body. These happiness molecules help in reducing the levels of stress and depression in our body. Thus, we can say that music and raga therapy plays a very important role in our life, because the base of all diseases is nothing but stress.
Hospitals across the globe have experimented with classical music and have come up with extremely positive response from patients suffering from various ailments. Now let's try and understand the process in a more scientific manner. Our brain experiences four different types of waves, namely alpha wave, beta wave, theta wave, and delta wave. When we go about our daily chores in our life, and when we are calm, we are experiencing the alpha wave. But when we experience strong emotions, we slip into the beta wave.
We are under the influence of theta waves when we are at our creative best, or sleeping, or meditating, or experiencing an inspiring mood. Lastly, we use delta waves when we are in deep sleep or deep meditation.
So when we hear different kinds of music, the music actually affects our brain's alpha, beta, theta, or delta state, thereon affecting our moods, which makes us react differently.
Today, music and raga therapy is increasingly being used to manage stress and promote wellness and overall physical rehabilitation.
In today's fast-paced world, we experience stress on a daily basis. Reducing stress is very important for our well-being.
Anyone can enjoy the benefits of music and raga therapy, either by listening to it on their home systems or even using headphones.
Very correct, Shalini. Now let us go into a little bit more detail on how music promotes healing.
Classical music is the key to mental and physical health. Our brain responds very positively to classical music by moving from beta state to alpha, then the theta, and finally it reaches the delta state. In Indian classical music, the ragas have the ability to calm the nerves and put the listener in a relaxed mode. human body behaves just like a musical instrument. It responds and resonates in consonance with music. And this response makes our body undergo changes of heartbeat, breathing, blood flow, and circulation of energy in various parts of the body.
We will now tell you how this particular music and raga therapy session works and how you can prepare yourself to benefit from it.
The seven notes or the sat sur are a complete therapy in itself. What is important is how we use these seven notes in the form of various ragas to heal. We have tried to systematize the ragas with ailments to make it easier for the patients to listen to a particular raga for a particular ailment. These specific ragas keep the body balanced as the curative power of music emerges from the swaras.
Regular listening to a particular raga for a particular disease produces a network of sound variations. The muscle and nerves of the affected area are contracted when a music note is given and relaxed between the interval of the two music notes. Thus, during the expansion and contraction of the muscles and nerve endings in the particular area, blood flow is regularized. This enhances the energy flow in the particular area. One of the unique characteristics of Indian classical music is that definite times of the day and night are assigned for a particular raga. They must be heard during that time of the day because it's been created as per the body's state, so to have maximum impact. It is also believed that in this given period, the raga attains its melodic beauty and majestic splendor.
So, there are some ragas which are very attractive in the early hours of morning, whereas others appeal in the evening, and some only spread their fragrance near the midnight hour.
One of the interesting things about Indian classical music is that it has an overlapping benefit. In other words, one raga can be applied to more than one ailment at a time. So before we start the music and raga therapy session, here are some things we need to do to get the best desired results. Firstly, we need to find a place where we will be undisturbed, where we can attain a little peace and quiet. Secondly, wear comfortable clothing. Thirdly, if possible, adjust the temperature and light settings to your preference. This session will last for approximately 20 minutes.
We must now completely relax. Pay attention to every body part from head to toe. You can close your eyes at any time if you want to. Pay attention to your breathing. This will lead you to a balanced level of oxygen and allow you to relax. During this process, your breathing will change. It may even become flatter, lighter, slower, faster, deeper, or even unrecognizable. This is normal because your body is reacting and balancing itself. Pay attention to your breathing. This is a way to move your concentration from the outside world to inside. Play the audio and let the music fill your senses. After listening to the recommended classical raga for at least 20 minutes, the session of music and raga therapy comes to an end.
Remember, you may need to use this therapy more than once per session to achieve the desired results.
Be patient, wait for some time, and try again. Avoid having long music sessions on an empty stomach. An ideal music session has to be of an hour with two or three short breaks in between. Most adults need 7 to 8 hours of sleep each night. You know you're getting enough sleep if you don't feel sleepy during the day. But if you dread going to bed each night, that means that you have a problem called insomnia.
Insomnia means little or poor quality sleep. Women are twice more likely to suffer from insomnia than men. Also, insomnia tends to increase with age.
Insomnia is the body's way of saying something isn't right. It's not really a serious health problem, but it can make us feel tired, irritated, and depressed. It can also make it very hard to concentrate during the day.
There are many habits that we develop to cope with insomnia, such as going to bed early to catch up on some sleep, resting in bed with our eyes shut. These habits only weaken the brain's sleep system, and the brain associates this strongly with wakefulness, thus worsening our condition.
Despite the pervasiveness of insomnia in today's society, it's largely being ignored by the medical community. As a result of which, insomniacs have been left with two options: either to take sleeping pills or to live with the problem. However, because of their potentially serious side effects and decreased effectiveness with habitual use, sleeping pills are not the solution to insomnia.
But with the power of music and raga therapy, one can improve sleep and cure insomnia to a maximum effect.
Music and raga therapy is a treatment that promotes relaxation and sleep. It reduces stress and negative emotions, and it improves overall well-being. Music and raga therapy is not only effective, but it's also very safe. By learning to sleep well, you will feel more energy and joy and be more productive.
The problem of insomnia or sleeplessness occurs due to the clouding of consciousness. When the mind is filled with unwanted thoughts, a person cannot sleep. So calming the mind by removing unwanted thoughts is necessary if you want good sleep.
Rag Darbari can be effectively used to get rid of sleeplessness. This raga soothes the mind and stops the clogging of thoughts. The swaras, when unfolded, ooze calmness and serene peace, allowing a person to have a good night's sleep.
Come, now let's enjoy Rag Darbari Kannada, sung by Shri Shrikant Deshpande.
Ah!
Another rag which helps in dealing with insomnia is rag Bhagishri. When we focus and listen to this raga, thoughts which generally block our sleep start going away, even stop. The notes of this raga play a magical trick in soothing the mind, and sleep takes over the listener eventually.
Just relax and enjoy rag Bhagishri on the flute by Pandit Nityanand Haldipur.
Mm-hmm.
few days, you will rediscover the magic of a good night's sleep. And within a few weeks, your mood and energy will improve.
So from now on, have a great sleep and say goodnight to Insommia forever.